Welcome back to Nier, part 9. We're joined again by Dej.
Hello.
Anyway, be careful, Deji. There are stuff like demonic giant spiders, light that can blind you, but cute seals that are too cute to attack. Oh, by the way, there's also sharks that can attack you if you fish them.
Actually, we don't attack you. We don't attack you. We're just really difficult to get caught.
That sounds like a description of.
It seems like a lot of rude, ill-tempered people live here.
Wrong town, bud.
I'm sorry. The people in the other village have sticks even further up their ass. So.
Yeah, then we haven't even begun with them, Shiroi. Trust me. isn't it so enjoyable when you get to a town full of unlikable people?
Well, just hope that that town doesn't get destroyed as a result of them being a-holes.
Well, then I won't care, because if they're acting like assholes, and if they were.
Yeah.
If their assholery caused their town to be destroyed, then they've got no one to blame but themselves, really.
You'll be the judge of the result when it comes to that one. Anyway, let's go back to the lighthouse lady to give her fucking ladder.
Like, say they were doing nothing but mooning the enemy.
I thought you said
she were
here.
Folks call her the lighthouse lady, right?
That's Yoko Toro.
Well, let's go check the lighthouse.
Sorry, can you say that, Dej, again?
I said moon. I think that's Yoko Toro.
Yoko Toro.
Yeah. What an absurd waste of time this is.
You never know, Book. The rewards may be worth it.
Hey, Grimoire. Can you turn into a bird and fly me to the tower?
Can you seals quit lying around?
But don't you mind me?
They're lazy.
Fucking piece of shit.
Remember, guys, there's a difference between.
I see what you did there.
Remember, guys, there are.
Someone does.
Well, also, yes.
Gabe, stop blinding me, please. You have no idea how it is playing with
TV. Deji, Siri, what are you guys talking about?
Personally, I don't think it's that bad, honestly.
No, I know. Anyway,
yeah, Brian and Flash.
I'm talking about the lens flare.
Not even much of a splash.
JJ Abrams. It's the irritator all over again. Anyway, let's talk
about. Imagine a JJ Abrams movie with 40% more lens flare.
Alright, I think this time we actually get to voice her, Pedro.
I think that would cause seizures.
Coming in.
Oh, you. What do you want?
We have retrieved your letter.
Pulls Minoru's leg. That's why he.
That's no excuse. It's his job to deliver the mail, no matter what. Didn't he take the postman's oath? The postman's oath?
Yeah, that's what we thought. The thought that anyone would actually bother to write your letter staggers the imagination.
Oh, but Vice, weren't you talking about the postman's oath too?
Yeah, the previous part, yeah.
I think I remember now. Such a rude book, I'll have you know. This is from someone very dear to me. Well, I suppose I should give you something for your trouble. Cue Life is Beautiful from Deadly Premonition.
Wow, 1,000 gold.
And then the kazoos come in.
Oh god, kazoos. And
then, before and we get to that LP, I'm buying your kazoo.
And then Papa Nier starts saying, hey, Vice. I think I can predict what's gonna happen with this coffee.
I don't know, Teogo. It kind of, when you think about it, Vice kind of is near Zack.
Also, yes, Drips.
I trusted you for all these years, and now you're bringing in kazoos.
Anyway, important side quest. You'll be this guy, Drips.
Hey, you there? Have you seen my Max around? Sorry, I don't know a Max. Max is my dog. He's been missing since yesterday.
Max, the beloved dog.
Oh, I see. Any idea where he went?
Please don't say near the mansion.
He usually likes to run around the northern plains. Most of the time, he just comes and goes, but I haven't seen him in over 24 hours.
Oh, thank God. Okay.
Yeah.
Dog astray. Hey.
Well, if I find him, I'll make sure to bring him back.
Hey.
Thank you. Something wrong there. That was nothing, just a little choked up of my dog is all. Okay, well, don't worry, alright. I'll do what I can.
We'll see.
I hope so.
What happened to the dog?
The cries of my dog are screaming from my head.
Yeah,
every
very good. And blah, blah, blah.
It hurts like
anyway,
hell.
we collected both of the ingredients for the tavern lady and the bulbs for the flower girl. So might as well give them to them.
Every night I'll wake hearing her screaming.
Daddy, I want a pony!
Wait, no, she never said that.
Anyway, first let's go to the tavern.
Or whatever. Point is, I love my daughter, okay?
I'll be this guy. Hey, you ever heard that Evelyn Popola sing? This actress is actually very funny.
Ooh. Everywhere I go. Sure, Devla sings here all the time.
But what about Popola?
I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about the two of them singing together.
No, I've never seen that.
They used to come here and sing all the time, but now they're so busy.
Well, I guess being mayor does that to you.
Hey, you wanna get them to come back and sing for us? Yes, there. You actually have to put the band back together.
How are we supposed to get the freaking mayor of all things to take her day off?
Well, don't forget to. Well, don't forget, Dwibs. There's no power up like singing. Or dancing, in the case of the words.
Using a mission from God. Anyway, we got, there you go, the ingredients.
Grandma's old-timer digestive elixir.
Yeah, it's basically for her grandma. So we only have to get it to her and we should be fine.
So basically they invented indigestion tablets.
Well, remember, Dweebs, this is the far future, so Maddie...
And Zach,
there we go. Let's see if Devola can say something.
Can I ask you a favor, Devola?
Devola. Sure.
Oh, you're asking for a favor? Well, yes, now I've heard everything.
True, actually.
Shivika, I heard you and Poppy sing at tavern. We never got a chance to hear it, so... Please?
Wait, you want to hear me sing?
Us.
Yeah, together.
Oh, us. I didn't get that. Well, Papa's been swamped lately, so I haven't sung with her in forever.
I don't know, honey. He constantly asks us to do everything for her, so I don't see how she's that swamped.
Yeah, I mean, she kind of just sits
around. I'm guessing she has to do
everything.
I'm guessing she does a lot of paperwork.
Yeah, that too.
If she's up for it, I'm willing.
Because that does require a lot of sitting, and it does get boring.
I don't know, Joe, but King Edma also has plenty of paperwork to do, and he's still got enough time to unite the yokai and human world. So,
didn't things kind of not go so well for him?
A fiery mythological demon. That's kind of a
true.
Also, hey, she's just like her friends. She's getting us to do everything for her too.
And didn't King Genma kind of end up having his kingdom kind of ruptured?
His right-hand man wanted to dethrone him, but got convinced with the power of friendship to desist.
Not so much that, more like...
beaten by living shit, I'll be honest.
I'm just trying to correct for an initiate. It's not power, it's more so the fact that he's incredibly racist towards humans, and by proving to him that humans can be capable of good through the trials he made over the course of the movie, he convinces him to give humans a second chance.
That's racist.
There's also a racist character. Well, there's also the subplot that he grew up with his grandpa from an early age, teaching him that humans are the devil and shit because of an ancient war that happened. So it's kind of one of those things where he's been inducted into hating humans since an early age. But go ahead, sorry, Joe.
Anyway, this side, no, don't worry. Completing side quest unlocks your garden, possibly the most tedious activity in the game.
Just like gardening itself.
Yeah, and why? Because gardening requires real life counters.
Mm-hmm.
So you plant your seeds, you need to wait hours, you need to water them, you need to wait hours. And maybe, just maybe, you may get the seed you need.
Throw in-game hours out the window for that?
Hold on,
because they wanted to pay tribute to seamen.
And you actually need to, if you want to get some specific seed, you need to start do actual, you know, biology and planting them in specific combinations. True, you can manipulate your PlayStation 3 or Xbox 360 clock in order to skip the time, but that just means you have to do the thing in the game, save, quit the game, manipulate the clock, go out again, rise, rinse, repeat for multiple times. It gets annoying real fast.
This is starting to remind me. Go ahead.
Thankfully, the only thing you need is for a specific side quest, which I'm not gonna complete, sorry, and for an achievement / trophy. And even then, Pedro may remember, but help me kinda with it.
Basically, so is there a particular reason why you needed to get those trophies?
Only for showing stuff at the end. Basically, for the sake of closing all circles with it. I'll tell more when we finish the game.
All right.
Sorry. Anyway, go ahead before we get to Yona. Go ahead, Pedro.
No, actually, no. I'd rather pay attention to the Yona scene.
Alright, bro.
All the shiny things.
Yeah, as I mentioned, you get items after each major story event in your house, so it encourages you to keep checking. Alright, let's go talk to her.
Dad, everything hurts.
It's alright. I'm gonna make some medicine for.
With a fish. Actually, I'm jesting, but yeah, fish's internal organs actually very useful to cure some disease.
I need to take it anyway.
Okay, Apparently, I'll take it.
Good girl.
In a more abridged way, but even the Bible actually guessed some of that.
Uh-huh.
Hi, Dad.
How are you feeling?
Great! The pain is totally gone.
Yay.
That's fantastic, Yona.
Now I'm gonna go to a dangerous temple and get myself injured again. Bye, Daddy.
Thankfully she's not gonna. She's gonna behave and be home for now.
I need to go talk to Popola. Stay here this time and get some rest, alright?
Alright.
Actually, we can get actual side quests from her.
Hey, Dad. I've been going to try making stew. Do we have any venison or wheat?
A deer wheat stew? That sounds...
No, it
that
doesn't.
That sounds
it
nice.
It doesn't at all.
Deer is grizzly.
No, you can make deer stew, but with beef? No.
Why would you want to mix the two anyway?
She's not good at cooking, but she wants to. Goddamn it, she tries.
You turned down the ingredients.
Really? Oh, thanks, Dad.
Basically, she's
kind
of like, for example, I think there is a staple of each Tales of Game. In each Tales of Game, there is a specific character who is terrible at cooking and it shows.
Always.
Personally, I think she just needs to stop playing Cooking Mama.
Learn how to actually cook.
Bison, Papanir will cook. Yeah, we'll talk about this.
We got something to say.
Oh, no. No, nothing at all.
Wow, he's going full old Jeremy Irons.
But she puts her heart into it, and I love her for it. Only a real jerk.
Papanir has so much patience with her daughter.
Do you think I am?
Did you hear me imply anything of the sort?
Yeah, he has a point. He didn't ever imply it otherwise. Well,
good luck. Yes, just make sure she doesn't literally
just good luck.
Yeah, let's make sure she doesn't literally put her heart into it.
We'll actually collect the ingredients and see what the result is.
I was gonna say, I hope she doesn't literally put her heart into it.
No.
That'd be bad.
That would be impossible unless she has the curse of Davy Jones.
Might as well, since you delayed.
This is starting to remind me of that one of my favorite jokes in Sonic and the Secret Rings in 3 minutes, where specifically referencing the side quests. First 550 bones, 550 rings, do my laundry. And it's a constant loop of that. It's just that constant theme of people asking you to bring and do shit for them.
All right, let's talk to Popola.
Got a letter for you.
Shiroi?
What the hell is going on?
Oh, thank you.
You'll be back up, yeah.
Sorry about that. Oh, dear. Also, what do you mean, what's going on outside?
What's wrong?
I don't know what's going on outside my house, because I'm hearing, like, music. I'm just wondering.
I don't hear anything.
It's me, from my end.
He says that a horde of shades have appeared
in the area.
Oh, well.
It's bad news. My weapon was damn near useless against the face there.
So we introduced a new concept here.
One that will hopefully allow us to circumvent that without
perhaps
having to fight.
There's some way to strengthen that weapon of yours.
There's a shop at the entrance to the junk heap that might be able to help.
Yeah, you might wanna straighten it so that it takes longer to break, because that's a pain.
If you bring them raw materials, they can make new and powerful weapons.
And even make the ultimate weapon.
Wrong, wrong Square Enix.
You get something similar to the ultimate weapons, but they're different, remember, based on weapons of Dragon Guard.
But it's not
that.
Free, no.
Ultimate weapons from Final Fantasy VII, right?
Was it ever free?
They'll cost you around 1,000 gold or so.
Technically, Dredge, it started in Final Fantasy VI, so...
Facts.
But VII was the one that made it extremely popular, because up until the point...
Can I skip Popola?
Yeah, I'll say after this dialogue.
Sure, what is it? Do something?
Yes.
How about now?
I heard you and Davoli used to sing in a tavern, and I was one.
Yeah. About time you pay something for all the shit we did for you.
Oh my goodness. We haven't done that in a long time. And I don't...
You don't dance?
No, I'm sorry. I just don't think I can do it.
That would mean I would have to get up from this chair.
Hold on. So in True Blues Brothers tradition, we need to give her that extra motivation to...
Why not?
Well, I need to sit and drink and sing in public.
Wait, she can only sing when she's drunk?
Oh, wait. Hold on.
I'm a little shy. You know what I mean.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
She needs to get drunk.
She's one of those people. You go out in a group of friends, just like, no, I'm not singing on the karaoke.
Trust me, Shiroi.
Like 15 pints later.
trust me, Shiroi.
Isn't tavern popular, I'm sure.
Yeah,
that rabbit hole goes a bit deeper than you can imagine.
Okay.
Oh, shoot. And here I...
They don't have this drink anymore.
Yeah, she needs even a specific drink, and
this
just
bitch
wait.
Is
hold
such
on,
a pain in
hold
the
on.
Ass.
Hold on, Pedro. just wait until you know what this drink is actually made of.
Jeez.
It's gonna make you question a lot of stuff.
Yes. Let me guess.
Is it the blood of the sheep we've been killing?
Yes.
No. But we're gonna deal with that another time. But now we need to get to the jungle.
Fighting through...
No one remembers. Anyways, I was mentioning Final Fantasy VI is what made the ultimate weapon first, but 7 was important. Because up until the point, the most powerful weapon in Final Fantasy usually was the Excalibur.
Yeah.
Anyway,
That reminds me too. You know how in Kingsglaive we saw the diamond weapon?
Hmm?
Episode Pronto explains its origin.
Anyway, there's something shiny
That's
there.
Pretty cool.
But that'd
be canine we were looking for. No, doggo.
Where is...
Doggo's dead.
Oh, snap.
Apparently was killed by the shade.
Dang, that's sad.
Let's go analyze him as old before we actually can defeat those.
You're
actually a bit powerful here, so you actually need to be careful.
It's a
being
sent to the Shadow Realm, so there are...
No, it's not the Shadow Realm, it's an alternate dimension. We have
anyway.
Ocean Dragon Ball Z, though.
Got something to say. After the events of this game, Nier decided to open his new Swordum online sword shop.
What's it called? Sword Art Online?
No. These swords are actually based off video game swords, and it's called www.forward/.com.
Hold on. Good, Luke.
Okay, that's actually...
Man, it's gonna be pretty upset.
Yep.
Hey, wait, I mean the dog has something in his mouth.
Wait, so the dog's actually dead?
It is.
Some kind of leaf. No.
What a bummer.
Shiroi, get used to it. By the end of this game, you're gonna need your tissues.
Okay.
This is a rather dangerous location for leaf hunting, and where this decision caused the animal is die.
Well, at least you can do is bring the leaf back to the old man.
Alright, let's maybe...
Well, we
hold
found
on.
Him. It looks like we're too late. This is gonna be hard for that old-timer to deal with.
Be they dog or man, dwarves, is Shulk's website called backslash.com?
Nah.
Oh, yeah. Vice being apparently an immortal being, he actually never questions about that.
It's starting to remind me of that side quest in Lightning Returns where we had to tell Sorrel that her father is dead.
See there.
Yeah. You know, the more you talk about Final Fantasy 13, the more I'm just questioning how that game even got that far. Got improved.
Kitase being very condescending.
And as for the sequels, Dead Sea, Square Enix trying to recoup their losses from
the
first game.
Sales figures, so...
Yeah, there's that.
But yeah,
basically, they wanted the first one to sell 10 million units, but they did it so two cheaply made sequels to cover that.
But yeah, this dialogue actually reinforced a bit Vice and Papa Nier's friendship. I mean, so let's go talk to this guy. I'll be voicing him.
Where's the old man that lives here?
You mean Granddad? He passed away. His heart finally gave out of me, so not only the dog is dead, even the old man is dead.
Jesus Christ!
I guess they can be together?
Looks like he went with his best friend after all.
But wait, there's even more.
Oh, hold on a second. His dog had this leaf in his mouth when we found him.
That's the herb Granddad used for his heart medication. Maximus has been fetching it for him.
That's great.
I suppose I owe a great deal. I can't give you much, but I hope you accept this. Take some money.
Yes.
Oh, the exact
faithful animal.
For the weapon thing.
You think Max and Granddad are together in heaven?
I do. I'm sure of it.
Let me guess. By the end of this, Grimmar Vice is gonna learn the value of human lives and shit.
More sooner than you may think, Pedro.
It seems like he already is learning that, honestly, Michael.
Anyway,
he did admit that he's rusty at this.
We got the stew ingredient.
Thanks, Dad. Hold on. I'm gonna start cooking right away.
A book is going to have an existential crisis.
What should we need to remind her?
As
a chef,
my
guess is it's best to not burn stuff. So might as well go with that. I forewarn you, no matter what your choice, just do it on a
song. Come on, I wouldn't think it's something like
So just the result of what happens changed based on what you tell her not to forget?
Yeah, this dialogue in particular will change.
The ingredients are recognizable, but God sent me also.
So by reminding her not to burn it, she doesn't cook it enough.
Dad, aren't you hungry?
I sure am, Yona, and boy, it smells delicious.
Poor Yona.
It tastes like the flower of a cave. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Yay!
One vomiting session later.
I'll wait right here and not get into any trouble.
Okay.
She's gonna die in the next bar, isn't she?
No.
Then we're on equal ground.
Also, we stole her in the prologue.
Anyway, next part we'll actually go to the junk heap. We'll actually go to the junk heap and see what awaits us there.
Will Popola finally get up from her chair? Stay tuned.
will the mayor and the tavern lady get together again?
You know,
Pedro, actually, I never thought about that particular aspect of the game like that until you mentioned. So,
which
congratulations.
One?
The fact that Popola never sits her ass.
She does jack shit.
No. She literally does nothing aside from telling you, go this for me, go here for me. Like, and she does nothing but just stand there. And even when you ask her, hey, by the way, could you read out with your sister and sing for all time's sake? Only if I'm drunk.
Trust me, by the end of the game, she's gonna get her ass up.
Papa Nier, you are much too nice for your own good.
And here I thought that the special drink she needed was just, you know, what some singers eat. You know, a bit of water with lemon put into it to clear the throat properly.
Wait until we heard the ingredients, but see you for the next part.
See you, everybody.
See ya.
Bye.